Hi, in this video we will continue with the loft series. If you didn't watch the first video, please watch it first and then come here to watch this video, because I will not repeat things that I already said in the first one. Here we will learn about other features and other possibilities in this tool. This shape here, I will use it as the path for the loft. And these shapes here, I will use them as the cross sections. So I will select the path, go to compound, loft, and I'm using the percentage feature and instance, the default. And now I will click get shape and pick this one. So I will have this loft from here to here. Now I will click here and choose 100%. That means the end of the path, and I will choose this cross section. So now the loft blends between this cross section and this cross section. Now here I have some, you know, some strange result because of the radius of the cross section and the fillet. I can go back here. Since I use the instance feature, I can reduce the radius a little bit. So now here, let's say I want this cross section to continue for 10%, then blend. I will type 10, then get shape, choose the same cross section. And like we said in the first video, this resolution here will happen between between one cross section and the cross section before it and the cross section after it. Now here I don't have a cross section, but what I have, if I go to path, if I go to the line, I have two vertices. So this 5x5 will happen between this cross section and this knot, and between this vertex and this vertex, and this vertex and the last cross section. So now let's say I want this geometry to be narrow, starting from this point to, let's say, somewhere here, and I want to create some small fillet. So what I can do, since this one is at 10%, I can type here 12, get shape, and choose the small circle. And then I can type 40% and pick the same small one. Then 42 and pick this one. So we will have something like this. Okay, now let's say I want somewhere between here and here, I want the shape to have a rectangular cross section. So I can type, since this one 12, let's say I will add 20, get shape, and pick the rectangle. Then 30, well, let's say 35%, and pick the same rectangle. Here you can see that we have some twisting. I will select the small circle I used between here and here. I will add an edit spline and go to spline sub-object level, select this one, select the spline, and then I will rotate the shape a little bit. You can see in the top that it is rotating, and we don't have this twisting anymore, so I'm satisfied with the result now. Okay. I can also, if I want to, go to this rectangle and change the corner radius to have smooth edges here. I can increase the corner radius. Now I have this. I will increase a little bit the resolution of the mesh. Make it, let's say, 10 by 10. Now let's try one of the strong features of the loft. You can find them here in Deformations. Today we will learn about one of them, which is scale. I will click the scale and this graph will open. Generally, this sometimes it's intimidating, this kind of graphs for users. But when you understand it well, it's not that difficult. So now this red line here represents the path. This is the beginning of the path, which is here, and this is the end of the path, which is here. We have now 2 points. The dotted here are the cross section I added, and those two here are the two vertices of the path, two knots. Before inserting any new control points, if you click move, and if I select this point, for example, here you see two values. The first one is the percentage. That 100% means that this point is at the end of the path. If I select this one, it will be 0%. That means this is the beginning. The second value is the the scaling value. 100%, that means no scaling. If I select this one, let's say, and if I drag it down, I'm scaling down the shape, and it will scale from here to here. I will make it 100 again. I'm scaling up now. I will make it 100 again. Now let's say I want to do some scaling somewhere here. What I can do, I can click this button here, insert corner point. I will add a control point somewhere, let's say here. You can see immediately the resolution increases. And if I'll right click and then I'm in the move now. If I drag it down, see the scaling happens from here to here and from here to here. I'll make it 100. I can change the position of this control point along the path by changing this value. I can drag it manually, or I can type a value, let's say 55%. Okay, so if I want to constrain the scaling between between these two areas here without affecting the rest of the shape, I will click insert control corner points. I will add a point here and a point here. I can zoom in, but I will add another control point here. Now, if I drag a selection over these two here and I drag them down, now I have this scaling that's happening here. I can move them all together. I can move this one here a little bit. So here you can see the transition is faster. And this one, I can move it. I can make it. You can copy paste the values here. For example, if I want the same scaling, I can click here, Control C, and then click here, Control V. So, and I have the same scaling. So this is a very powerful tool. You can go now and experiment with it. So basically that's it for this video. Hope you like it and you learned something. And now try to, you know, create your own path, your own shapes, your own cross sections, and try to create something different. Play around. It's a very powerful tool. And if you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.